All right, good evening. It's my pleasure to welcome all of you to our annual Kindergarten Information Night, our first and hopefully only virtual information night. My name is Dr. Trevor Allward, and I am the Deputy Superintendent for Grand Blanc Community Schools. For most parents, enrolling in kindergarten and sending your child off to school is a bittersweet time filled with both joy and anxiety. The good news is we've been doing this for a long time, and we have an excellent staff here to ensure that your child has a very successful start to their childhood school experience. Tonight, we will look a little different from our traditional information night. At the end of tonight's presentation, we will move into a live Q&A session with me, and then you're invited to hop into your principal's Zoom meeting where they will introduce you to the building staff and answer any questions you might have. And those links will be available at the end of this presentation and back on the website where your building link is located. First, I will share information with you regarding our overall kindergarten program and also information about other support programs and services that are available to your family. So in Grand Blanc, we have a tradition of excellence that is unlike any other. I often tell our new staff that I would put our district up against any school in the state or nation as it relates to our performance relative to our size, funding, and demographics. So what makes our district so successful? A common purpose. Our mission statement is a living, breathing thing in Grand Blanc, and it aligns a purpose for all of our staff, from food service to bus drivers to teachers to principals. We all make excellence our mission.
There is a change in the air. It's happening in each of our schools and in every classroom. Things feel different, new, better than ever. And tomorrow, they'll be better still. This is Grand Blanc. This is Grand Blanc Community Schools, positioned to be the hallmark in public education, where students engage in cutting-edge curriculum and state-of-the-art technologies with an emphasis on individual autonomy and self-direction. Where students participate in sports, bands, clubs, and other extracurricular activities that help them to actualize their own unique genius, freely and without fear. Where students learn that helping others through volunteering and service learning leads them to the unremitting pursuit of the highest human ideals. Inspired by our past, but driven by the future, we are implementing a rigorous academic program with a wide range of course options. Students can now customize their educational experiences to meet specific career and life goals, and master what's needed for what's ahead. What's happening here is not normal. It's extraordinary. In our elementary schools, students are learning digital citizenship and coding, experiencing service learning opportunities, and participating in fine arts programs along with mastering core curriculum. In our middle schools, students are using advanced technologies in the classroom, exploring a wide variety of electives, and developing critical thinking, problem solving, and communication skills. In our high school, students perform experiments in modern labs for college credits and perform on stage in hit musicals for standing ovations. Students earn advanced certifications in career and technical educational programs or obtain college credits from the University of Michigan and other institutions of higher learning. Students learn Chinese, French, German, and Spanish for careers in the global marketplace, and excel in AP biology, chemistry, and calculus for admission to top pre-med and engineering programs. There is no stop in us, only go. Our momentum pushes us forward. We have strength in numbers and are rich in diversity. We thank our alumni for proving there is nowhere Grand Blanc graduates can't go. That's why, instead of looking behind, we're looking beyond. The tradition of excellence. It is our legacy. It's what defines us. But instead of saluting our history, we are focused on making it. This is Grand Blanc. This is Grand Blanc Community Schools, one of the best school districts in the state of Michigan.
We align the focuses of our mission to something we like to call the portrait of a graduate or the portrait of a Bobcat. You should find a copy of this illustration in the virtual packet. This portrait demonstrates our commitment to the development of various aspects of students' learning. Things that are not necessarily always evident in a test score, but we know as partners with our community and parents are critical components to successful students. What are the parts of a Grand Blanc grad we are talking about? Well, the hat is dedicated to the discovery of profound learning, and as you can see, we are looking to promote reflection, curiosity, and perseverance, amongst other things. The heart relates to demonstrating exemplary models of character and judgment by showcasing commitment, kindness, courage, and integrity. The hands are an unremitting pursuit to the highest human ideals, such as fairness, diversity, and service to others. The legs show emphasis on individual autonomy and self-direction, which include promoting innovative thinking, initiative, and supporting emotional intelligence. And finally, the feet promote global experiences in life and living through civic engagement, teamwork, and cultural appreciation. As we continue to formalize our portrait of a graduate, we feel that over the next 13 years of your child's education in this partnership with you as families, it is our charge to continue to assess our students' progress towards achieving our mission statement, which begins today in kindergarten for your student. Now, there are so many other staff members that support our students and families here in Grand Blanc who are available to address any concerns you might have either by phone or email. If you need assistance, we ask that you call your designated elementary school and be directed to the appropriate department or individual. Our district department leaders include Clarence Garner, who will be retiring after over 30 years at Grand Blanc Schools in June. So that will be myself in that superintendent role in the fall, but right now I'm the deputy superintendent. Amber Hall, who is our district curriculum director. Karen Smith is the director of our food service program. Barb Bailey is our director of special services. Kim Kuhn, who is our director of transportation. Brandy Anderson is the director of children's garden. Elizabeth Thiem is our associate coordinator for parents as teachers in GSRP. And in a brand new role for our district, Sonia James is our instructional equity coordinator. She's also the principal at Mason Elementary. So if you have questions about Latchkey, early childhood programs, food services, special services, transportation, or other district resources, please reach out. Their information can be found on our district website. You'll become more familiar with the staff at your building over the coming years, but remember that Grand Blanc is a district of over 8,000 students, and we actually have 9 elementary buildings within Grand Blanc Community Schools. These are the principals throughout the district that lead our various elementary buildings. When your students finish elementary, each elementary feeds into one of our 2 middle schools. From middle school, all students go on to Grand Blanc High School. Additionally, students in grades 2 through 8 who live in the district can apply to attend Perry Innovation Center. Bobcat Virtual Learning is our completely online branch and services students in grades kindergarten through 12th, with an online curriculum guided by Grand Blanc teachers. The program was jump-started by the pandemic, but was a planned expansion that will continue into the future for families who would prefer an online option. That being said, this program requires a high level of commitment from parents and guardians, especially at the elementary level. There is no live instruction, and especially most younger students will need to be heavily assisted and guided through each lesson by an adult or a learning partner. So now that you know who will be working with and for your students, let's take a look at what a typical day might look like at school for your kindergartner. This video was made prior to the pandemic, so you won't see the masks or social distancing in place currently, but you may see some familiar faces.
So in music class, we basically just do a bunch of different musical activities, or the kids call them games. And this includes singing, dancing, playing instruments, and using a bunch of different manipulatives, such as scarves and finger puppets and a bunch of different things like that. Up the ladder, down the ladder, one by one, the ladder, up the ladder, down the ladder, one by one. Up the ladder, down the ladder, one by one, the ladder, up the ladder, down the ladder, one by one. And stop. Does anybody remember where the djembe is from? What country? Yeah, right, Riley? Remember?
Africa.
That's exactly right. Nice job. All right, get your hands ready, guys. Here we go. Up the ladder, down the ladder. One the ladder, up the ladder, down the ladder, one by one. I say up the ladder, down the ladder, one by one. The ladder, up the ladder, down the ladder, one by one. Okay, we're gonna go this way.
Today, the students are in my PE class, and they're learning different activities through games, and they're getting a nice workout rotating in different stations. Remember, every 15 over and unders, you guys are switching. Make sure you guys are on the mat so you don't hurt yourselves. Make sure you're on the mats. Keep jogging, guys, outside of the cones. Keep going, outside of the cones. Keep going. Remember, guys, this is one-on-one, all right? You're playing one person versus the other. If your bottom comes off, make sure you go to the end of the line. Good job, guys.
A typical day in kindergarten math is run like a workshop. We focus truly on number sense and get them engaged at an early age. And we really focus on problem solving and get them engaged through hands-on learning. So we'll start whole group with our problem solving and then get them into independent practice. Where the teacher then will work with small groups at their independent level and coaching them. You'll see lots of things going on in a workshop. Kids working hands-on. You'll see paper pencil. You'll see all kinds of different things, really raising problem solvers for the future.
So during this part of the workshop, the children break out into independent practice. The teacher also works with a small group to continue the problem solving. But the kinds of number sense that they're engaged in, you will see this number line the student is working with. They're adding on one more, two more. They'll do subtraction. They do that physically so that it makes sense to them and they feel what numbers are. You'll see some children doing counting collections. That's where they have a collection of objects. And counting seems simple to us, but it really is a number sense. Can they anchor themselves to 10 and some more? So they will cluster things and count by twos, fives, and tens. You also will see children making choices from baskets. This is all number sense activities from 1 to 100 and beyond. They make those choices themselves. You're doing the number of the day, aren't you? So what's your number today?
17.
So what are you doing with 17?
We need numbers.
I see that you've made tally marks, and you've broken 17 into a number bond of 10 and 7. Very nice work. Children will also be working with the hundreds chart. And you can see from what they're doing that they're engaged, they're enjoying it, and they're making sense of numbers.
Right now, the children are doing literacy centers. Basically, it's a literacy experience that the children do either independently or collaboratively in a group, and they focus on literacy skills. So for instance, we have a retelling activity. We have poem activities. We also have a word building activity. a sight word activity and a literacy alphabet book activity. Okay. Okay, who remembers how we start our sentences? Uppercase letters. Did you guys all, everyone look at the first sentence. Did you all put uppercase letters at the beginning?
I forgot.
I know, I noticed hers too. So yep, just switch it to uppercase. And then don't forget what goes at the end. What goes at the end of your sentence? Do you remember?
Period.
Yes. This is our interactive poem wall, and as you can see, the children are able to read the poems independently, and also some of them choose to get a dry erase board and write the poems and copy them from the wall, full of sight words that they know and that they learn throughout the kindergarten year. Good job, Meadow. I'm glad you're doing that. Right now, we are doing a guided reading group, which is a small group reading instruction for differentiated teaching to help students develop reading proficiency in a small group. Okay, boys and girls, today we're going to read a story. Let's look at the front of the book. Can you guys guess what the story is going to be about?
Traffic jam.
A traffic jam. Can you look at the picture and tell it's a traffic jam?
Yes.
Who can name some of the, maybe some of the cars or trucks that are in the traffic jam? Andrew?
Motorcycle.
A motorcycle. Noah?
A bus.
A bus. Michaela?
Police car.
A police car. What do you think, Caden?
A tow truck.
A tow truck.
A bike.
A bike, okay. Well, we're going to see this word inside the book that we're going to read, and I'm going to spell it out. And let's see if you guys know this word.
C.
C, very good. Right now, we will be doing a shared reading experience where the children either join in or share the reading of a book with me, supported by the teacher. Basically, we use an oversized book, and I model proficient reading skills. Okay, boys and girls, we're going to read a story today. It's called I See Shapes. We've read this one time before, but we're going to review this story. Who remembers this, the word that we talked about last time? C. Can we spell C?
S-E-E.
S-E-E. C. So I see shapes. I'm going to call on some students to help me find the word C on the different pages. So, Skylar, can you come on up? Do you see the word C on the front of the book? Very good. So can we read the title together? I see shapes. What shapes might we see in that story? Lucas.
A square.
Maybe a square.
There's writing to be done each and every day in kindergarten. Me as the teacher, I can write to the students, I can write with the students, and the students can do the work on their own using the to, with, and by method. We write about their experiences, their thoughts, and their ideas each and every day in different content areas and just what happens in their life. Here we go. This is a little bit of transition words and how-to writing. Okay, so boys and girls, you have been doing lots of different stories about how-to. We've read lots of different books that give directions about how to do something, like how wax gets turned into crayons, or how trees become paper. I know some of you at your table, you're writing how to brush your teeth. What I want to show you today is I want to write down some words that I want you to start trying in your writing. These are called transition words, and they just tell the reader of your work one step to the next step to the next step. So some of these words are going to be like math words. These are going to be the ordinal number words. These are words like first. So after each mini lesson that happens in Writer's Workshop Daily, I will conference with students individually on what process they're working on in Writer's Workshop and see if they're using some of the things from the lesson in their daily writing. Hey, can you tell me what's going on? What are you working on today?
In Grand Blanc, we have a very hands-on approach to science. Everybody meet Clarice.
Hi, Clarice.
She's an albino snake. Isn't she cool?
Yeah.
How are you?
Nice to see you.
Can I bring her?
I won't bring her.
And I have a question.
What do you think, Chloe?
He's a boy.
We learn about living things and the basic needs of living things, and we like to explore living things here. So these are millipedes. See if we can get them out. Put your hands out. Mm-hmm. You can reach in there and grab them, boys and girls, if you can find them.
I found one.
Put your hand out. Put your arm out.
Can we take anything we want out of there or just the millipede?
We'll take the millipede out of there and see what it feels like.
Ooh, it's so smooth. I know, I just found one. It's curled up.
I found one. They like to hang out on the ground, don't they?
Yeah.
Yeah, mine's not moving.
Why do you think he's not moving? Do you think he might be scared?
Mine's like,
it's okay.
Just curled up.
Yeah, mine's curled up too.
Mine has a little sting on it.
We also work on pushes and pulls in the classroom. So here we have Cecere and Sydney, and they are showing us how ramps work and how far the Jeep went. I wonder what would happen if we raise the ramp up a little bit. Think it's gonna go farther?
Nope.
You think so? Let's see.
Can you make it smell a sense to smell this?
Orange. Let me check. Yeah.
We also work on our five senses, on seeing, hearing, touching, tasting, and smelling.
So there you have it, life in kindergarten. Now let's get to some of the nuts and bolts of enrolling your child in Grand Blanc. Due to legislative changes at the state level that began several years ago, there have been some big changes regarding age requirements for kindergarten. For tonight's purposes, the key takeaways are that your child must be 5 years old by September 1st or 5 years old by December 1st with a signed waiver to be enrolled in kindergarten or young fives in the fall. So Grand Blanc Schools only offers full-day kindergarten sections. The intent of the full-day kindergarten experience is to provide depth in all areas of the curriculum. You will find a kindergarten curriculum guide in your virtual packet that I encourage you to review with your child prior to the start of kindergarten. All kindergarten students will receive instruction in the areas of language arts, reading and writing, math, science, and social studies. Probably the single greatest thing that you can do for your child prior to kindergarten is to read to them and let them read to you. Try very hard to be patient with them making mistakes. That's developmentally appropriate. Remember, learning is the process of gaining knowledge, and how do we do that best? By making mistakes. That's okay. I know many of you will want to do your own assessment to see where your child is at before they enter school. So please use this curriculum guide, but also know that this is what our staff will be teaching your child during the year, not what they what they necessarily need to know to start. Grand Blanc also offers a full-day Young Fives experience at all buildings. The criteria for placement for Young Fives changed a few years ago. Priority is given to children with birthdays later in the year, especially September or later, and parental requests when placing students in the Young Fives program. You will be asked to sign your child up for what is called a Bergantz screener. This in-person screening assesses gross motor skills, fine motor skills, recognition concepts such as identifying letters and numbers, and language development such as speaking skills, problem solving, sorting, answering simple questions, and identifying objects. This assessment also includes a parent feedback section that allows you to share information about your child as part of the overall assessment. The screening will take approximately 15 to 20 minutes. Earlier we talked about the major components of this assessment and how it will be used in conjunction with your child's birthday and your consent as a parent to determine if your child is eligible for the Young Fives program. This short video clip gives you an idea of what to expect when bringing your child in for their Bergantz screener.
In Grand Blanc schools, we invite our students to come the spring before they start kindergarten, and they take a Brigance assessment. This is just a way for teachers to get acquainted with the children to get comfortable with us a little bit. We just check to see where they are developmentally. We're looking at their physical, their gross motor, their fine motor skills. We also know that some children come to school having already learned some things. We like to know that. So what do they know about numbers? What do they know about letters? One of the important things that we start with is their language skills. So the very beginning of the Brigance, we are asking some questions, some personal information, name, birthday, that kind of thing, just to see how the kids are remembering things and what their language sounds like.
What is your name?
Morgan.
Do you know how old you are?
Five.
Five. And when is your birthday?
December 13.
The next part of the assessment is also language. This is checking vocabulary. It's really important that children have words for what they know. And so the simplest thing is to do your body parts.
What do you call this?
A thumb.
What about this?
Pointer.
This part of my finger right here. Your part right there.
Nail.
Nail. Okay. What about this? What do you call this?
Chin.
So the next part of the assessment is really looking at the child's physical development. So we are going to look at gross motor, looking at can they stand on one foot, and you'll see that there are a couple of different parts to that. Gross motor really impacts fine motor also. So the next part after the child gets up and physically moves around a little bit, they're actually going to be drawing some shapes, and then that will go into writing their name. Those three parts of the assessment are very connected, with the large motor part being the part that needs to be in place first, and then usually children come along with the other two parts.
Okay, Morgan, we're going to stand up. You want to come up right over here for me, please? All right, now I want you to look at me. Can you do this? Can you stand on one foot? Let's see how long you can do it. Let's count. One, two, three, four. Oh, can you keep doing? Try again. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Good job. Okay, now we're going to print some things about yourself. Will you print your name up here for me, please?
We know that early understanding of letters and how they work is really important for kindergartners. We don't expect kindergartners to know all their letters when they come in, but it is a good indicator that they're taking on some new learning. So we do ask kids to say their ABCs, and then we do a little bit of letter recognition to help us know where to start with them in the fall.
Morgan, can you say your ABCs for me?
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
Oh, you know what? Can we do, would you do me a favor? Will you say them like A, B, C? Can you do that for me?
A, B, C, D.
Another important part of kindergarten is math. That's a foundational time for number sense, is before kindergarten and kindergarten. So we like to see how children are doing with their math concepts. So we'll work a little bit with shapes with them, some sorting, and then just some number concepts that are early that give us an idea of where to start with them in the fall.
All right, Morgan, I have some shapes here. I'm gonna dump them out. Will you do me a favor? Will you put all the large blue shapes over here for me, please?
The last part of the assessment, we look at how children interact with books. We are not actually reading to them, and they are not going to read to us, but we're looking to see, do they know the front of the book, the back of the book? Do they know how to follow print from left to right, and then where would they go next? Those are what we call book concepts, and it's really important that children have a lot of interaction with books before they come to school. This just gives us an indicator that they are working with books, that they love books, and they have a chance to do that.
All right, Morgan, I'll give you this book. Can you show me the front of the book? Excellent. Will you show me the back of the book?
So that's our Brigance screening, and we know we've got somebody ready for kindergarten.
Now, if you look at our virtual information packet, you will see the actual schools that will offer Brigance screening dates and the dates that these assessments are offered. If the date that the assessment scheduled at your home elementary building does not work for you, please sign up for an assessment in one of the other buildings. You can do this by contacting the school where you need to have your child complete the assessment, and all of the phone numbers for the elementary buildings can be found in your virtual packet. Our focus at the kindergarten level is on the social, emotional, physical and intellectual growth of students. Our staff members recognize and encourage students to engage in activities to promote a positive self-image in a variety of different learning experiences. As mentioned earlier and seen in the video, our staff focuses on reading, writing, math, science, social studies, and teamwork. This approach is based on work out of the National Association for Education of Young Children. Our curriculum is challenging, engaging, developmentally appropriate, culturally and linguistically responsive, comprehensive. It is likely not what most of us remember kindergarten looking like. Our staff wants the students active and engaged. There is a focus on comprehensive, evidence-based learning, and you will see the curriculum build on prior skills and experiences. If you want more information regarding this developmental approach, please visit www.naeyc.org. Now here's a quick video of what to expect your child to be learning next year.
In kindergarten, we're learning how to read. We use our eagle eye and we're stretching pieces apart to make a word.
In science, we're learning what living things and non-living things.
In math, we could use a plus sign to write our number sentence.
In writing, I am learning how to write a how-to book. I am writing a book on how to read.
I'm learning about goods and services in social studies. We dressed up something that we wanted to be. I was a dentist.
In science, we are learning living things and non-living things. We made an experiment to see what living things need to grow. How to use our equal sign.
Bucket filling.
You're learning to fill other people's buckets.
The big word that we learned in math.
Which is?
Communicate.
Respectful, responsible, be safe.
The Michigan Legislature instituted Michigan's third grade reading law last year, which requires all students in third grade that have fallen one or more grade levels behind in reading to be held back and not enrolled in fourth grade. Our in-district analysis was showing that roughly 2-3% of our students didn't meet the exemption requirements and would not move on to fourth grade. Nearly all of those 2-3% of students had 10 or more absences, which we know is a huge at-risk indicator. School Every Day is our local awareness campaign from our Proactive Attendance Committee, also known as PAC. What you need to take away right now is that consistency in attendance and reading with your child early and often are critically important. We continue to work on exciting initiatives with our staff in kindergarten through third grades in the coming years to make sure our students are staying on track. Our transportation department handles the monumental task of transporting students in our district to where they need to go on a pinpoint schedule and to get kids home there safely and on time. Lunch is priced at $2.50 and breakfast costs $1.75. If your family qualifies for reduced lunch, the price lowers to 40 cents for lunch and 30 cents for breakfast. Applications for free and reduced lunch are available online. There will be paper copies available at your building. If you require a physical form, if you need assistance filling out the form, please don't hesitate to contact Dining Services at 810-591-6674. Menus will also be sent home each month with your child and are posted at www.gbcs.org/diningservices. Until the end of the 2020-2021 school year, the USDA has given direction that all children under 18 should be fed for free by schools due to the COVID-19 situation. You are more than welcome to attend the Grab and Go drive-through our staff offers every Friday. They are at Brendel Elementary and East Middle School from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. and McGrath Elementary from 2 to 4 p.m. Drive up, tell them how many children you're feeding, and they will place a bag of breakfast and lunch items and milk for each in your trunk. This might be a great way to introduce your child to school lunches ahead of time, as the staff is packing up many of the same foods they would serve on site. I think one of the neat features about our food program is that your child will get an automatic meal account, and you can put money into your child's account electronically at any time with school pay. That's our new form of online school payment. We encourage the use of this online payment method, and you can also log into your child's account at any time to check your balance and actually see what your child has been eating each day. There's more information about this in the virtual packet, along with contact information, should you have any questions. We are very proud of our award-winning Children's Garden Preschool and Latchkey program. Latchkey is before and after school program for students and is available before school from 6:30 a.m. and until 6 p.m. After school students at Cook, which also includes Mason, Brendel, McGrath, which also includes Anderson, Reed and the Perry Center. Myers and Indian Hill programs, they are housed at Perry Center due to space limitations. Those students are bused from one building to the other for school, so they would be dropped off and or picked up at the Perry Center. Registration will be available as a link on the Children's Garden website beginning March 8th at 9 a.m. Families previously enrolled in Children's Garden will have priority registration the week before, as in past years. More information and registration when it becomes available will be on their website at www.gbcs.org/CG. In order to make our kindergartners feel more comfortable with all these new people and places, we like to bring them into the building to meet the principal and teachers before the school year begins. One of the favorite activities during this orientation is the teddy bear bus ride. Each building will have buses running every 15 minutes or so during this time, so that our kindergartners can hop on there with you or whomever is accompanying them to experience what might be their very first bus trip. You can see the dates listed here. More information will be sent out from your building with those dates as they grow closer. You'll find information in your packet regarding the requirements for both vision screening and immunizations. Please note that a completed immunization record is required for enrollment unless your doctor assigned a medical waiver for your child or you have a certified non-medical waiver form issued by the County Health Department. So, enrollment checklist. You need a copy of your birth certificate, not a copy of the official birth certificate, but it must be notarized. Up-to-date immunization record is required. Please refer to the chart in your folder, as it will outline exactly what immunizations are needed for students ages 4 through 18. This is good information to have when you're checking in with your doctor to ensure that your child's immunizations are up to date. Your proof of residency. One document must be a closing document or rental lease agreement, and then two other pieces that can be either a current bank statement, current credit card, consumer's bill, or phone bill. Your physical form and the vision screening. Ask your physician or call the County Health Department. Your building may provide an update later on, but as of right now, we don't have any clinics scheduled at the buildings due to COVID-19. So again, our online enrollment module is right on our main webpage. Please make sure to go to that website, and we've made this process as paperless as we can. If you have any questions, you can contact your building for more information. The best first place for you to contact with a question or concern is always your elementary, as I stated. But know that we are always here to support you as a district as well. The administration building is located behind Perry Center. We have a district website at www.gbcs.org with news and updates and links to all of our departments and school buildings. We also have an app, Grand Blanc Community Schools, and it can be available or can be downloaded on a mobile device from the App Store, Apple App Store, or Google Play. You can receive notifications through the app when messages are sent out. We're also on social media at GBCS Bobcats and post updates there as well. Grand Blanc is a proud Positivity Project partner school, which means that we learn 24 character strengths throughout the school year. Things like perseverance, integrity, teamwork, fairness, forgiveness, and leadership. We learn how to identify those strengths within ourselves and in others with the goal of learning about one another and building relationships. Teachers rotate through short lessons and activities involving each of those character strengths weekly, and you are welcome to find out more information about this amazing character education program and follow along next year at www.posprojects.org. In recent years, we've tried to bring in examples of excellence, our tradition of excellence, to perform live to our kindergarten families. This year, Mr. Simmons, one of our Rockstar Elementary music teachers, provided these performance videos for you. So not only are RGB students performing together apart, but in the second video, a 2016 graduate of Grand Blanc is accompanying students on the saxophone. That Grand Blanc grad was actually just hired to be the music director at Powers Catholic High School in Flint this year. So enjoy this example of unique genius from our mission statement.
I am strong when I am on your shoulders.
So that concludes this portion of kindergarten orientation and kindergarten information night. If you have any questions or would just like to listen, I will be holding a live question and answer immediately following this presentation at this Zoom link. You are then invited to go live with your building principal at 7 p.m. You will need to return to the orientation webpage and follow the link to your building. Traditionally, we break out into building presentations at the end of my presentation. However, this year, we will be asking you to join your elementary building virtually at 7 p.m. following my live Q&A session. So we are so excited to welcome your youngster to Grand Blanc Community Schools and have them contribute to the tradition of excellence and the pursuit of their own unique genius as we continue to build a Bobcat for the future. Welcome to Grand Blanc. Take care, everybody.